Good morning, Malacañang Press Corps, and welcome to our press briefing this morning. In the cabinet cluster meeting earlier, the Department of Transportation presented to President Ferdinand R. Marcos Jr. some findings and recommendations on the airport incident on January 1st. DOTR Secretary Jaime Bautista led the presentation. Ibinahagi niya ang mga kailangan gawin para sa improvement ng mga sistema sa CAAP at sa airports. Magpaliwanag din si Secretary Ivan Uy ngayon ng Department of Information and Communications Technology tungkol naman sa communications at connectivity aspect ng insidente. At para bigyan tayo ng mas comprehensive explanation, kasama natin ngayon sina DOTR Secretary Jaime Bautista at DICT Secretary Ivan Uy. Let's start with Secretary Bautista. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Daphne. Good morning, everyone. Yeah. Thank you for joining this press briefing. This morning, we met with the President and gave him an update of what happened during the January 1 issue that we had with the CNS ATM of the Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines. We also made some recommendations on how we will move forward. And the President is very much aware of what happened, no? And he supports our recommendation to implement future requirements necessary for the upgrade or improvement of the CNS ATM system, no? Which includes hardware and software maintenance, hardware replacement, ultimate fallback system for software redundancy, and the need for an independent CNS ATM in a separate location. He also instructed us to continue the maintenance of all existing equipments, no? And at the same time, he wants us to fast-track the arrangement for a maintenance agreement with Sumitomo Antales, who is the provider of the system. No? So, thank you.
Okay. I'm sure there will be some questions in a little while, but let's move on to Secretary Ivan Uy. Do you have anything to report, sir?
thank you very much, and good morning to everyone. Well, as Secretary Jimmy Bautista has mentioned, during the sectoral cluster meeting this morning, we did discuss on the incident that happened last January 1. And so far, from the cybersecurity aspect, there doesn't appear to be any cyber-related incident that triggered the incident. It was basically an electromechanical malfunction that triggered the whole incident. But nonetheless, we took the opportunity to conduct a thorough review and cybersecurity audit of the whole system, since we're already there, in order to ensure that the system is adequately protected from any cybersecurity threats, no? As you very well know, immediately after our incident, a few days later, the U.S. Air Transport Management System failed, entire United States. And a few days later, the Canadian system also failed. We still have no clear report from both the U.S. and Canada as to how or why or in what way their system failed, except for they're publicly announced that it is a system glitch or a software issue. So we're still awaiting word from them and exchanging notes. However, we're not taking any chances, and we are conducting a thorough assessment of our own internal system just to make sure that we have the proper systems and security in place to prevent any issues on the software and on the cybersecurity aspect. So this will require upgrades. This will require probably replacement of some equipment, hardware, and software. We'll perhaps give you a further update as soon as we have other news. Thank you.
Okay. On the SIM cards? Any?
Yes. So on another topic, we're shifting to a new topic. Okay. With regards to the SIM card registration, the recent report I received is we have more than 20 million already registered SIM card users. So we are roughly 1 month from the implementation, from the release of the implementing rules and regulations. And we've already achieved more than 20 million registrations. So we are progressing very, very fast. And I'd like to thank the public, the general public, for being very responsive to our appeal to register as soon as possible. And in order to help our remote areas, because the bigger issues actually are those remote areas where they do not have any Wi-Fi connection where they can do the registration. So we have launched a SIM card registration caravan that is going to all those remote areas. And we've started the first caravan is we did at in Ifugao, the mountain province, last week. And in the next few days, we have a three-day SIM card registration in the remote areas. January 25, we're addressing Region 1, 7, 8, 10, and 11, which will be in Ilocos Norte, Cebu, Leyte, Bukidnon, and Davao del Sur. Mostly at the municipal auditorium, no? We are providing a press release as to where these sites will be and exactly which auditorium, municipal hall, or gym of those municipalities or barangays that we'll be deploying. January 26, it will be in Cagayan Autonomous Region, Region 2, Region 3, Region 4A, and Region 9. And on day 3, January 27, it will be 4B, Region 5, Region 6, Region 7, and Region 13. You'll be getting a list of all the specific areas where we will have internet connectivity, either through our digital transformation centers, our telecenters, or our free Wi-Fi areas where there will be people who will assist in the SIM card registration. These are all remote areas in the country where they cannot connect. So far that's all on the SIM card registration. There have been some issues that has cropped up and we're currently also addressing some of those issues that were not anticipated before, like there are SIM card wholesalers that have bought thousands of SIM cards and now they're not able to sell it and it's going to expire because if they are not able to sell it, and it doesn't belong to any person yet, baka maputol dahil hindi na rehistro yung mga SIM card. So anyway, we're working with the telcos on how we are going to address some of those issues. That's just an example of one of them. Anyway, so that's it. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you so much, Secretary Ivan Nguyen. Now let's open the floor for some questions. Okay, first up, we have Eden Santos of Net25.
Hello. Thank you, Ma'am Daphne. Kay Secretary Bautista po, can you elaborate lang po yung binanggit ni Pangulong BBM yesterday dun sa media briefing na wala naman pong plano ang administrasyon na isa pribado ang operation ng NAIA. Pero meron yatang kinukontrata na private sector group from New York na magmamanage po ng operation. Tama po ba yon?
Thank you, Eden. No? Ang ibig sabihin ng presidente, no, hindi naman natin ibibigay sa private sector yung assets ng NAIA. No? Ang ibig niyang sabihin ay it's the private sector who will manage the operations, no, through a concession agreement. No, which is what we have been doing in two airports now, no? Sa Cebu at sa Clark, no? Cebu is operated by GMR Megawide, no? Although yung asset talaga ay asset naman ng gobyerno, kaya hindi naman na privatized yung infrastructure, no? This is also the same with the operations of Clark International Airport, no? Yung asset remained with the government, but yung operations ay ginagawa ng private sector.
Are we expecting po na parang kagaya sa mga expressways, eh baka po magkaroon ng pagtaas sa mga airfare or sa mga ibang services po ng ating mga paliparan?
Hindi naman automatic na tataas, no? Kasi yung regulatory function will remain with the government, no? And the government will have a say in the rates that the operators will impose, no? So hindi ibig sabihin na tataas kagad, no?
Okay,
thank you so much po.
Next we have Alan Francisco of PTV4.
Hi ma'am, hi sirs, to Secretary Uy. Sir, what challenges have you been encountering regarding the SIM card registration, sir?
Yun ang na-mention ko, no? One of the challenges is there are just a little issue. The main one, of course, is accessibility, especially in the remote areas. Dahil maraming mga kababayan natin may mobile phones at nangangailangan nila magpa-register within a certain period of time, pero walang mga signals, walang mga wifi connection, at dapat magbiyahe pa sila from their islands or from their communities to the munisipyo para makakuha ng signal para makapag-rehistro. So that's one area. So we're addressing that now by deploying now those connectivity. Most of those connectivity will either be mobile, meaning we're bringing our satellite systems and all of those para may connectivity sila doon sa mga areas na yan. The second challenge is marami pa lang tayong mga kababayan na walang ID, lalo na sa mga liblibang lugar po, no? So how will they now be able to register and validate their identity? So yan, we need to take that up with our team to address how we are going to validate kung wala naman silang ID. Never pa sila nakakuha, hindi naman sila nagmamane, walang sasakyan doon, so walang driver's license, hindi naman sila nagbiyahe, walang passport, hindi naka-register sa SSS, sa GSIS, sa PhilHealth, Pag-ibig, wala. So ang ano lang sa kanila is sedula, which we all know it's easy or senior citizen ID, which we need to validate. So we also need to help them and see how we are going to ascertain their identity. So and then of course on the commercial side, yung mga resellers, yung mga distributors ng mga SIM card, since nag-announce tayo nito, bumagsak ko ang bentahan nila ng SIM cards. Dahil dati, itong mga scammers, itong mga sindikato, bili na bili ng SIM card, tapon. Eh ngayon, alam nila na hindi na nila magagawa yan. So bumagsak ngayon yung bentahan ng SIM cards, which we actually anticipated that will happen. After all this registration, there will be much fewer SIM cards that is going to be sold, because there will be no more demand. And most likely, karamihan siguro mga SIM cards binibenta sa airports. Mm-hmm. Dahil sa mga travelers, foreigners that will be coming in that will buy their SIM cards. But in terms of the local population, the sales will be very, very small once this happens. So those are the things that we are studying and anticipating and preparing for. Thank you.
Okay, thank
follow
you.
Follow up lang, ma'am.
Okay, follow up.
Yeah. Sir, mahirap i-validate yung identity ng mga kababayan natin in some remote areas, which leads me to my next question, yung sa national identification, sir. I mean, mas makakatulong sana yon kung meron ng ID yung ating mga kababayan. Please clarify that, sir.
Tama po. At yun ang medyo, that's a big challenge, no? And you may have to address that question to the Philippine Statistics Authority since sila ang primary agency that's implementing the national ID. Pero ang nakikita namin po na solution dito, hindi ko pa din-discuss with the team, no? Is that pag mag-SIM card registration kami doon sa remote areas, dadalhin na rin namin yung national ID system. Para right there, pagka-rehistro yun ng national ID, mag-SIM card registration na rin sila. So we shoot two birds with one stone, di ba? Mas madali yung deployment. So yun yung mga solution na pinapackage mo namin.
That's a great idea, sir. Uh-huh. Great idea. It looks like a popular idea here.
Oh, yeah. I see everybody nodding their head.
Okay.
Thank you po.
Thank you. We have next Alvin Baltazar of Radio Pilipinas.
Secretary Uy, magandang umaga po. Follow-up lang po doon sa problema doon sa commercial side nung sa SIM card. Base doon sa pakikipag-usap niyo sa mga telcos, magkano yung malulugi sa kanila kung hindi madi-dispatch siya yung mga SIM?
Wala pa kaming idea doon. We'll have to talk with them to see, no? Kung marami ba sila na-produce. But they already knew that the SIM card registration law was going to be signed last September. So I'm sure they've already anticipated na kung mapipirma yan, if they are, you know, doing proper business planning, alam nila that the demand will significantly decrease. So if I were them, I would not order new SIM cards from manufacturers. I will just make sure that the existing inventory ay maubos na lang. And then dahan-dahan lang deployment. So it's a business planning side on their part on how they should. Sa tingin ko, hindi naman malaking malulugi sa kanila. Dahil kung magaling sila sa planning, alam nila na itong batas, pag lumabas, babagsak yung demand. At pagbagsak ng demand, it will be foolhardy for them to still continue ordering the volume of SIM cards that they used to order.
Secretary, nabanggit nyo kanina, no? Mukhang bumaba nga yung benta kasi yung mga scammers. Masasabi ba natin nagkaroon ng chill effect doon sa mga scammers itong SIM card registration?
Well, gusto ko lang matanong ko sa inyo, dati before this law was signed, ilang text messages na tatanggap nyo sa isang araw at ngayon, ilan po? I'm sure all of you felt a significant drop. Dati, I get about 6 or 7. Now, 1 or 2. Tama, di ba? So, I think that answers your question.
Okay. Next, we have Tuesday New of DZBB.
To Secretary Bautista, sir. Sir, nung binigay niyo po yung initial result of the investigation doon sa NAIA incident, ano po ang naging reaction ni Presidente? At can you share to us, sir, some of your recommendations po para matugunan yung problema na ito?
This is not the first time that we reported this to the president. No, we reported this even earlier. No, a few days after the incident happened. No, and nakita nga niya na kailangan magkaroon ng some improvements in the maintenance of the system. No, and ito yung pinag-usapan namin na as much as possible, KAAP will continue to maintain the system daily, weekly, or monthly, no, as what the maintenance program requires, no. And ang sabi nga niya, mas mabuti kung magkakaroon tayo talaga ng permanent maintenance agreement with the suppliers, no. Kasi hindi tayo nagkaroon ng permanent maintenance agreement with them, no, since the system's warranty expired in 2020, no? As early as September, we have been working with Sumitomo Antales about this, no? Meron lang mga some issues that we need to thrash out, no? We need to settle some financial issues with them, no? Meron silang claim against the government, where meron din tayong claim against them, no? And we're just trying to settle this, no? And hopefully by the end of this month, meron ng clear indication on how we will be able to settle the issue, no? And isa sa mga recommendation niya ay still enter into an agreement with the supplier, no? and separate the issue of claims, no? Which we have already communicated with the supplier even before, no? We met with Sumitomo Antales a few weeks ago, no? And we suggested that we negotiate for a permanent maintenance agreement, no? Pending the settlement of the issues, no? So yun ang aming mga ginagawa ngayon, no?
Follow up lang, sir. Yung mga naulit po kasi yung incident last January 1 to last week, pero parang iba naman yatang problema yon. Medyo maikli yung oras na ginugol doon sa pag kukumpuni nung something technically na problema. Yung mga ganitong incidents, sir, in the coming days or in the future, magkakaroon pa ba ng ganitong mga incident after these two incidents po?
Yung huling incident, no, this is a scheduled maintenance, no? Kailangan paayusin na natin yung second UPS, no, para magkaroon tayo ng backup, no? Kaya we made arrangement with the supplier, no, for them to be able to fix the second UPS, no? It was scheduled 4 o'clock in the afternoon, no? 4 o'clock in the morning, sorry, no? Medyo tumagal lang ng konti yung maintenance na ginawa, no? But these are all coordinated, no? And nagkaroon ng konting delays yung ibang mga airlines, no? But as early as 6 o'clock in the morning, operations was already normal, no? With all the initiatives, no, of CAAP, its engineers, proper coordination with the supplier, no, we're not expecting this to happen again.
Thank you, Tuesday. We have Ivan Medina of GMA7.
Secretary Bautista, sir. After the January 1 incident, you said that a big amount of funds is needed to implement the necessary upgrades at the CNS ATM. How much money are we talking about, and saan po natin ito isosource?
Unang-una, we need to upgrade the software, no? According to the supplier, they do up two upgrades a year, no? And since 2020, we have not had any of the upgrades, no? Wala pa silang binibigay na presyo as of now, because this will be part of the negotiation that we will do, no? But ang isa sa long-term solution namin is not just to upgrade the system, but to put up a permanent backup, no? Importante na merong permanent backup system, which can be located in another site, no? Which can operate simultaneously with the existing system, no? Which will be back up to each other. Normally, ganyan naman yung system natin, no? A system operating, let's say, in Cebu, together with the system operating in Manila, which will be the backup for each other, no? So, yun ang tinitingnan namin. We will need to prepare a feasibility study to do this, no? And for us to be able to determine the cost, which we will present to NEDA for approval and for funding, no? Either from ODA or from GAA. No?
Salamat po.
Thank you. Any other questions? Okay, Julie Baiza of 1PH.
Sir, yung sinasabi po ng Pangulo kahapon na magkakaroon ng management contract with the US firm, a group that runs several big airports abroad daw po. Gumugulong na po ba yun, sir? Nakausap na po ba? Or do we have a name nung specific company?
Actually, what will happen, ano, is that we are preparing the terms of reference, no? And this will be subject to bidding by proponents, no? So ito ang hinihintay namin, no? Kasi dalawa ang posibleng mangyari, no? One is for us to receive what you call an unsolicited proposal, no? na pwedeng kasama yung kausap namin sa New York, no? We will invite them to submit a proposal based on the approved terms of reference na, that we are now preparing, no? So yun ang possibility on the NAIA operations.
We have again from Tuesday New, DZBB.
To Secretary Ivan, sir. Sir, sabi niyo kanina, more than 20 million na po ang SIM cards na nairehistro. Ilan po bang milyon ang inaasahan nating dapat na mairehistro hanggang sa April? At kakayanin po ba yung mairehistro lahat, considering itong sinasabi niyong mga challenges po?
Based on the numbers na ibinigay sa amin ng mga telcos, we have about 140 to 150 million SIM cards. Ngunit hindi naman siguro lahat yon active. At kung maaring marami doon, ginagamit kasi ng mga telemarketers, ng mga scammers. So we are still figuring out kung ilang numbers doon ang non-legitimate owners, no, of those SIM cards. So, but with a population of 110 million, I think if we're able to register like 20 million per month, so we have a period of 3 more months, no? 3 more months. March, April, 3 more months. So that's 60, about 80 million. I think we are on track so far. And we'll play it by ear and see how fast we are able to deploy that. The law provides certain adjustments, no, that the ICT can make in case there are any gaps or challenges in the implementation of the registration. So we have those tools, and the law provides us with that discretion. If medyo kapusin tayo.
Okay, thank you very much. I think this wraps up our press conference today. And thank you so much to Secretary Jimmy Bautista of DOTR and Secretary Ivan Uy of DICT. Thank you so much, Malacanang Press Corps.